I want to be a veterinary surgeon. The dream of children who love animals and they want to make them better.
But it isn't very easy. We are going to tell you everything in this documentary about a veterinary surgeon. The dream of working in animal medicine is one that many people have, but few will ever realize. As you will see, becoming a doctor of veterinary medicine takes more than a love for animals. The process of earning the degree and then earning the trust of clients required many years of work and dedication.
You're probably close to your pets as they are part of a family, but consider of the millions of agriculture animals and horses that also need healthcare. Then think of the groundbreaking research that can improve life for both animals and people.
Now you're realizing how diverse a degree in veterinary medicine really is. Becoming a veterinarian is full of challenges, expense and sacrifice, but those who will graduate will tell you it's an incredibly rewarding profession and career.
So how do you become a veterinarian? First, you need a strong high school experience with good grades in math and science. This is also a great time to find a job working with animals in some way. Become involved with 4-H or FFA, or volunteer at local animal shelters or veterinary clinics. Then a minimum of 2 to 4 years of undergraduate studies in a pre-medical premium is needed before you apply to veterinary school.
Competition is fierce. There are only 28 schools of veterinary medicine in the United States and they accept less than 3,000 students in a year. This means excellent grades and good animal experience are needed. Once accepted in a professional school, a new student will find their days filled with lectures on physiology, anatomy, microbiology and so much more.
Whether in large lectures or small labs, veterinary students spend their days absorbed by seeing amount of science and basic medicines. As students move through 4 years of postgrad with education, they become more exposed to a wide variety of hands-on experience. From learning to perform physical exams and monitoring hospitalized patients, to participating in daily rounds and surgery in the teaching hospital, these soon-to-be veterinarians are seeing their education come together, and are eager to put their heart and the knowledge into practice.
After graduations, the studying is not over. Before a young veterinarian can be licensed to practice, they must pass state and national board exams and then continue their education by keeping up to date with new treatment protocols and technology which required continuing education. All of this is done to make sure veterinarians will provide the best diagnostics and treatments of animals and at the same time stand on the front lines of our community's public health.
Not all veterinarians will go directly into practice. Many serve in the military. Others become board certified in many special things. Still others find rewarding careers and research, keeping our nation's zoo animals healthy and even teaching the next generation of veterinarians. My name is Jenny McBrown, and I'm a veterinarian. I am 28 years old and I live in Amsterdam with my husband, my son, my dog and my 2 kids. I'm 5 years a veterinarian now and I'm still proud of it. My favorite pet is a cat. I really love them because they melt in your arms when you cuddle them. They also aren't loud.
After my high school, I did veterinariology. This study is called Faculty Veterinariology, University Utrecht. The education to be a veterinary surgeon is 6 years. When you complete the first 4 years successfully, then you have your doctorate. The last 2 years are postdoctoral researcher. In these 2 years, you learn everything to be a veterinary surgeon. You learn how to operate, how to examine and to treat someone, etc. Nowadays, it goes according to the bachelor-master system, so it goes different as in the past. At an earlier stadium, you learn how to be a veterinary surgeon.
The education to be a veterinary surgeon was various, interesting and intensive. It was very nice to do. Definitely, you can make all the animals better. Mainly old animals who have, for example, a bad kidney function, you can't fix the bad kidney. That's frustrating. You feel helpless.
I was interested in biology, the difference between organisms, the working from a beastly body with the processes. If everything is going to be alright, it's a miracle how much processes are in your body the whole day. You're going to be quiet if you hear that. The nature has very good meditate about it. For every animal you have to think different to come with a solution to make the animal better. There's a lot of diversity. It is absolutely not an office job. There's also quick action needed when there's an urgent case. You can't postpone your work because it has to be done now.
We work with 2 veterinary surgeons a day. One works at 9 till 3 o'clock and the other one works at 2 till 8 o'clock. The day starts at 9 o'clock with consults. Every 15 minutes a new appointment until 10 past 15. From 10 past 15 until 12 past 30 we do the operation program. From 1 o'clock the consults start again. At 2 o'clock the second surgeon starts with appointments. Sometimes there are operations between 2 till 4 o'clock. This is a job for the surgeon who starts in the afternoon. After that consult until 7 o'clock and from 7 till 7 past 30 we reserve for emergency cases.
Positive things are when a pet's treated well, that feels very nice. Or when you find a solution, also for new problems. When you're a veterinarian, you have to be very creative sometimes. Negative things are when animals are ill and when you can't save its life. And when people are going to the clinic too late with their pets because they don't have much money and can't pay a visit at the clinic. Sometimes you can't do anything anymore except putting the pet to sleep. At that moment, you're helpless. That's a chameleon. Dead animals are very nice. I really like them because they got the ability to change color. And they're exotic, so they aren't daily at your clinic.
I am pleased with the animals I got at this moment. You have to treat animals you know much about, because then you can treat animals better. Of course I am. I was attacked by a dog when I worked a few months at the clinic. A nerve in my arm was hit, so I couldn't work for a few months. The reaction of the owner was, "He never bites."